I've come to Chagford to do a walk around. It's going to be my first time walking around Chagford. It's a nice fine day. The sun is out and it's 12 degrees outside today. Yep, enjoy the video, guys. The swimming pool is closed for the winter and it's really nice. I'm impressed. Look at it. Today we're exclusively looking at Chagford. We'll just walk along the road, the small road, and have a look around. We are approaching a humpback bridge, so this will be nice to look over the bridge and look at the water. But here we are approaching the bridge. Are you all right? Nice view here. Are you alright?
Hello.
Fire station on Turn Lake Road. So far there's a few people walking around, but it is Sunday today. We've got some townhouses and houses so far. Isn't that exciting? You know, we're walking in from the outskirts and we get to see different things going in. We're still yet to find a village. But I suspect it's at the end of this road here. But this is an interesting arch house. And this is a really nice house. Bishop's house. That is a really fancy estate agent, Rendles. Rain coming. See the damn more hills down there. I don't know if you can see. I'm right in the village. I need to get back. I don't have an umbrella, so I'm going to get soaked if it pours down. Look at the estate agents. There's a quick nose here if you want to look at the prices. From 2020 in October. Just pause the video if you want to look at it slow. And that's the prices of 2020 from Rendell's estate agents. There's a lot of history in Chagford, and there's definitely got a feel of 100 years ago about it. So there we have it. That's the end of the walk. Seeing Chagford for the first time. My thoughts on it are historic. It's very quaint, and it's nice just to walk around and go to the nice cafes. And there's some really nice old pubs as well. So. And a nice little town square, so it's kind of really tiny, you know, but it's worth a visit just to spend, you know, I'd say an hour or 2 hours, you know, of a coffee or a drink. But yeah, it's a nice place. I'm happy I came. And check out the other videos. I've got plenty of walk around videos. I intend on going to different places and doing things like this. So yeah, it's just all fun and I get exercise. Peace. Got the rainbows out. Just on the way back, it's gone nice. The rainbow's out. Chickens, chickens. You know, this is as mixed as it gets. Blue skies over there and rain over here. We've got the full rainbow. The full rainbow. Ain't it stunning? Hello, what's going on? Well, I still haven't got home. I stopped because my GoPro fell off the car, believe it or not. I left it on the car and drove off, but it's okay, lens is not scratched. And as you see, the sheep are going crazy. I just went to the fence to get a picture of the pond. A video of the pond. And the sheep are just all baying, you know, and they're coming closer to us. I feel so terrified. And this one is coming really close. You're a brave one, aren't you? You're a brave one. That's a bit too close for comfort, isn't it? I kind of feel bad because I left Chagford because the weather turned a bit bad, but it was just a shower and now it's turned kind of beautiful and we have rainbow and the light is just amazing. And we've probably still got another hour of sunlight to go, but yeah, I hope it's been a good video for you today. But what I was saying before, we had the rainbow and I put the GoPro on top of here on its little tripod, and I just forgot about it and drove off. And then as I drove off, I heard it just fall to the floor, so I stopped the car in the middle of the road here and then just got it, you know. And thankfully the lens is not scratched in the main place, so it's just scratched on the outskirts of it. I thought for a moment I'd be going home and ordering a new GoPro, because it was just like, I've done that before as well. You put your camera on top of your car and you forget about it, you drive off, boom! Anyway, time to drive.